Welcome once again to Lehto's Law. Here's Steve Lehto.
Jamie sent me an interesting story out of Colorado, and it's from CBS4 Denver. Denver's top parking official fixed 21 of his own tickets by Brian Moss. Now, here's the thing. The question is whether or not this was legit, because he claims he had a good reason for doing it, and there's nothing wrong here. It's all above board. But it doesn't look good. CBS4 investigations found Denver's director of right-of-way enforcement received 21 parking citations on his personal car in 2020 and 2021. He ordered every one of the citations canceled, and he now says that he received the tickets while he was engaging in a secret mystery shopper scheme to test how well his parking agents were doing in handing out parking tickets. So he says that he parked his car illegally to test the system. And in 21 tests, they passed. So he just erased the tickets. The mystery shop campaign, cited by the man, was apparently known only to one other person. And this is his supervisor, who apparently backs him up on this. Now, the man himself declined to answer questions. And since CBS4 began investigating the 21 citations, the city has suspended the mystery shop program. The curious practice came to light when a whistleblower in the right-of-way enforcement division noticed what the man was doing and filed a complaint in September with the city board of ethics, suggesting that the man was engaged in questionable ethical conduct, using his public position to get those tickets taken care of. In the ethics complaint, which was obtained by the TV station, a supervisor underneath the man noted that he believed what he was doing amounted to fraud. Employees who receive a parking citation shall pay their citation, go before the parking magistrate, or schedule a court date to contest their citation, wrote the employee. And your tickets are like everybody else's. You got to fight them or pay them. None of that occurred with this man's tickets. Instead, he just ordered them dismissed. The employee called the man's actions unethical conduct by a higher-ranking Department of Transportation and Infrastructure official. The type of conduct found has resulted in disciplinary action and/or termination with past employees. So other employees had done this and gotten canned. This guy did it and said, oh, it's all part of a secret program. After being called out for the practice, the man wrote the ethics board stating, I did not violate my power. He went on to explain that all the tickets he received were in the course of a secret mystery shop program that tests the integrity of the various operations of the people who write the tickets. These accused actions are not an effort by myself to abuse my power as a director. He said it was all part of a strategy to determine if employees were completing their required responsibilities in handing out parking tickets. He said his supervisor was aware of what he was doing, and I have executed it frequently since my arrival to this department. Now, the executive director for Denver's Board of Ethics said after screening the initial complaint, board members felt this is something that should be investigated. She said it took a good amount of strength and character for that whistleblower to come forward. Now, the man who is getting his parking tickets erased said he would periodically park his personal vehicle at a meter or time zone to see if an appropriate violation has been issued. If one was issued, then I know our field staff is doing their job. Thus passing the mystery shop and ensuring operational effectiveness. I've always heard it called mystery shopper, but whatever. He acknowledged that vehicle control agents and supervisors were never informed of what he was doing so that the mystery shops are as effective as possible, he said. My accuser was not aware of the mystery shops, thus the reason he assumed my actions were a violation of city ethics. He said he frequently played the mystery shop role while he began his job with the city in 2019. Most of the citations he received were between March of 2021 and August of 2021. City records show in July and August of 2020, his vehicle was ticketed 5 times, with him ordering those tickets canceled, noting each of the tickets were written in error. They were written in error, which makes you wonder then, if somebody writes a ticket and it gets said that this ticket is written in error, then are we really rewarding the person who wrote the ticket and saying, yeah, you did your job. Well, your ticket was just erased as being written in error. Seems odd. Of note, during the pandemic, city employees were allowed to park for free at the Webb Municipal Building, but that free parking ended in June of 2021. Of the overtime parking citations that the man received in 2021, 15 came immediately following the end of free parking at that building where his office is located. Additionally, every one of the citations put on his SUV was handed out when the vehicle was parked within 2 to 3 blocks of his office on the 5th floor of the Webb building. So his mystery shop program is being conducted in and around where he needs to park his car. It's not being conducted out in various locations. And the question is he really testing the people on the force when he keeps parking the mystery shop car in the exact same area? I do see how a perception of these accusations could lead to a misunderstanding by someone if they're not fully informed of the reasons behind the actions. However, these actions were needed to perform the most effective mystery shop and keep integrity at the highest level within the department, he wrote. Meanwhile, the chief operating officer of the Department of Transportation wrote, "I am aware of the mystery shop parking program. He has informed me that he will park in and around areas of the city to see if the team would ticket his vehicle. The question is, when did he become aware of it? Did he notify him after the fact or before the fact? And was it really that smart to use his own vehicle?" Meanwhile, the chief operating officer appeared unaware that of the 21 tickets issued to the man in question, they were not from around areas of the city, but were all issued in close proximity to the man's office. Meanwhile, the Board of Ethics ruled unanimously on November 2nd that the man had not violated the ethics code because his purpose in implementing the mystery shop, which they capitalized, was to improve compliance levels within the department and that he was not seeking to gain or benefit personally. But he did gain and benefit personally because his car got to be parked near his building and didn't get ticketed. And he didn't have to go down and put money in the meter. So he did benefit, but they say he didn't. The board cautioned, however, that by using his own car and without standard operating procedures, the situation is likely to recur and result in an erosion of trust and leadership within the agency. The director of public information for the department told CBS4, "We believe the mystery shop practice lacked adequate structure. We have suspended the program while a department-wide policy governing the use of a mystery shop approach is developed with greater levels of review and control." Meanwhile, the whistleblower in the case left his job and moved to another city agency. So you wonder about that. But, you know, a police officer who gets arrested out, I don't know, sticking up banks, could just say, "I was just testing response time for the police." I've heard of stories about guys in volunteer fire departments who were caught starting fires so they could go on calls, just doing it to test response time. And you might say, "But Steve, let's assume that this guy legitimately did this. He actually thought, I'm going to park my car where I normally park it and see if it gets ticketed. And that'll be a test of the people who write tickets." What you would do is you would go to your supervisor before you do this, because that is not clear from the story, and ask and say, what do you think of my idea? I want to do this. And if the supervisor actually said, "Yeah, go ahead and use your own car. Go ahead and use your own car." You would then park the car in different locations scattered about the city, because presumably there probably are areas that get enforced very, very well. And there probably are areas that don't get enforced very, very well. And so you'd try it here, try it here, try it over here, try it over here. You wouldn't do it in the parking lot where you normally park over and over and over again, because that's what makes it look so bad. So if you said, "Steve, in your opinion, was there really a mystery shop program?" No, there wasn't, not in my opinion. But the ethics board believed there was. And his supervisors come forward and said, yeah, there was a program. And I know about it. Of course, the question is, when did you find out about it? And why does it appear that the mystery shop program benefited this guy? Because it just so happened to be his car parked where he would normally park it. You know? I mean, it's a little odd. But that's the whole point. It's very odd. And so CBS4 Denver's headline, I'm going to read this to you verbatim, just so you hear this. "Denver's top parking enforcer fixed 21 of his own tickets," by Brian Moss. "Fixed" is in quotes. "And Jamie sent it." Fascinating story. Questions or comments, put them below. Let's talk to you later. Bye-bye.
Thank you for watching Lehto's Law.
Three important things in your life: your health, your mission, and the people you love. That's it.